Hi, I'm Doug Seven, Senior Director in Microsoft Health Next, and welcome back to our video series on the Azure API for Fire. In the previous videos, you saw how Fire plays a role in modern healthcare systems and how the ONC final rule is really advancing the application of Fire in the US health system. In this video, we're going to talk about the Azure API for Fire, which is an Azure service that implements the Fire specification. As we discussed in the previous video, Fire is really the definition of a set of data elements known as resources. Some of the examples we discussed before were patient or condition or observation as different resource definitions that can be exchanged between systems using a set of APIs compliant with what is defined in the Fire specification. This is important because it makes this data available in a common and standard format, regardless of what system it's coming from. As Fire was maturing in its definition as a specification, we really started to think about how should we support Fire in the healthcare industry in the Microsoft Azure cloud. The Azure API for Fire was designed to enable the potential of health data in a hyperscale cloud environment for things like machine learning, advanced analytics, and artificial intelligence. In this case, we designed the Azure API for Fire to leverage the existing health data standards for interoperability, the HL7 Fire specification. That means that any system that can exchange data according to the Fire specification can exchange data with the Azure API for Fire. The Azure API for Fire is designed to securely manage protected health information, or PHI, in an environment that complies with all regulations for PHI in whatever region we've deployed into. We're currently deployed into regions all around the world, supporting compliance requirements in all of those regions. The goal of creating the Azure API for Fire was really to accelerate the outcomes that you can get from things like machine learning and advanced analytics and AI workloads. If you can bring data from disparate systems into a common standardized format like Fire and bring it into a single common data set in the Azure API for Fire, then you can start to explore what you can do with that data in different systems. As we think about how to enable modern health solutions in Azure, we really think about how we support bringing data from a disparate set of systems that may or may not have any ability to communicate or interop with one another today, and enable that data to be ingested and enriched and brought into a Fire-based system in Azure. The Azure API for Fire becomes that common data set where data from all these disparate systems can be unified according to the Fire specification. So regardless of whether it's an electronic health record system or a PACS system, a wearable device, or a CRM system, the data coming from that system can be ingested and enriched into the Fire format and persisted in the Azure API for Fire. Once it's there, then you have the ability to look into that data for what you're really trying to explore and do, whether it's machine learning or analytics or AI, the ability to query and provision cohorts of that data and use that data for meaningful workloads is really critical. Through a variety of capabilities we have to ingest and enrich data, we can bring data from a variety of disparate systems that may have no ability to interoperate today into a single data set based on the Fire standard. The ability to persist all of that data in one data set means that we're making new capabilities available in terms of what you can do in systems of engagement and systems of intelligence. You can query that data to find different cohorts or subsets of that data you might use for different workloads. You can apply that data into different systems of intelligence for things like machine learning or analytics, or you can just expose that data through a set of common Fire APIs to new systems of engagement, whether that be tools like Teams or Dynamics or third-party applications or custom-built applications or new applications leveraging standards like Smart on Fire. The idea here is that data comes from disparate systems and gets unified into a single common data set and then can be exposed in whatever way you need for the workload you're working on. All of this is enabled by a set of capabilities we've built in the Azure cloud. At the center is the Azure API for Fire, which is an implementation of the Fire specification. The Azure API for Fire implements the Fire specification without opinion. In other words, we implement the specification as it's written and stay true to the specification. If we feel that there's changes that need to be made to the specification, rather than deviating from the specification in our implementation, we work with the HL7 Fire community to see those changes through. On the ingestion side, we've built new tools for the ingestion of data to be able to bring data from disparate systems and convert it into the right format to be persisted in the Azure API for Fire. One of those tools is the IoT connector for Fire, which enables you to use connected devices, both real-time devices and sampling devices, to bring data into the Azure API for Fire. The connector will convert that data into Fire resources and persist it in the Azure API for Fire, along with data coming out of the EHR or PACS system. We've also built a tool called the Fire Converter, which enables you to use the $convert operation in the Fire specification to pass in data like HL7 V2 messages or CDA documents and convert those into Fire bundles where they can be persisted with the rest of your data. This is tremendously important if you have systems that aren't yet on Fire and you haven't implemented Fire APIs. You can pass in HL7 V2 data or CDA data and convert it to Fire and persist it with the rest of your data. Once data is in the system, you have the ability to query that data and export that data to use in secondary use scenarios. According to the HIPAA privacy rule, any secondary use of data requires that it be de-identified in the appropriate way. The Fire Tools for Anonymization is an open source project that we've built to support a variety of different techniques for the de-identification and anonymization of protected health information. The Azure API for Fire implements an export operation according to the Fire specification using the $export operator. One of the options you have when using the export operation is to apply the Fire Tools for Anonymization to de-identify the data on export. So we've taken the same code that we've written in open source and we've implemented it into the Azure API for Fire as an option for de-identifying data on export. This is perfect for a variety of secondary use cases where you want to export data, but you also want to abide by the HIPAA privacy rule for secondary use. When you point the Power BI Fire connector at a Fire endpoint, we'll interrogate the capability statement, and then you can define the relationships between the resources in the Fire service that you want to use within your Power BI environment, such as a patient and a condition. That data is then imported into the Power BI environment where you're able to create lots of visualizations of that data and do really powerful things. The Azure API for Fire implements the Fire APIs according to the specification. That means a wide variety of systems of engagement also have the ability to connect to those Fire APIs and use that data in meaningful ways. This could be mobile apps, web applications, Teams interfaces, or even Dynamics applications. It's tremendously powerful to be able to use a set of standards to bring disparate data together into a single data set and represent that data in a variety of different ways, but also to expose that data to new systems of intelligence and new systems of engagement. In the next modules, you'll start getting hands-on use with the Azure API for Fire. We'll deploy the Azure API for Fire sandbox using our open source GitHub project, and you'll be able to look at a variety of use cases where we've applied Fire in different scenarios. We'll explore the different capabilities of the Fire service, including the Fire Converter, the IoT connector, the tools for de-identification and anonymization, as well as the Power BI connector. Thank you very much. We'll see you in the next video.